Good evening, fellow vapers. This is Cass, and I'm back at you with another juice review. Today, we're going to be looking at an interesting juice that I picked up at the Vape Expo. Not a massively well-known brand. I don't know whether many of you know, but Italy has a huge vaping scene. They have thousands of e-liquids come out of Italy, and this is one of them. So let's get down to it. The e-liquid that I'm going to be looking at today is Duke by Royal Blend. Now, as you can guess, this looks a little similar to some other kind of branding. It looks a bit like a Jack Daniels label, let's be honest. It's clearly non-compliant as hell as far as the TPD goes. There's no warnings on it. That's about it. There's no warnings on it, and it's just a copyright waiting to happen. However, I did have a little try of this at the stand for these guys, the Royal Blend stand. I had to buy some straight there and then take it home. And what I'm going to be doing now is having a more of an in-depth taste of it and a bit more of a review. Oh, you know, that's the point of this video. But firstly, let's get a look at this bottle. They've literally tried to make it a hip flask. Now, you wouldn't be able to sell this in the UK, I don't think. This is a 40ml short fill, which means it needs one nick shot. You can have an 18mg nick shot to get just over a 3, or use a 15mg nick shot to get exactly a 3. But I've used the 18. It's all shook up. But it is literally a hip flask. Now, the one thing I will say about this, whilst the shape is interesting, it feels cheap as hell. It's impossible to squeeze. Like, this bottle is solid. And I noticed when I was putting the nick shot in, this cap, I can literally just pull it out. So I'm a little worried it's gonna dump an entire bottle of juice all over the top of my mod in a minute when I drip it. So let's get down to it. So let's look online and see what Royal Blend say about their e-liquid, and then we'll have a vape of it. Duke is a new sophisticatedly smooth tobacco with notes of an oak-aged whiskey. So essentially what we've got here is a smooth tobacco with a sort of whiskey flavor. I hope it's not Jack Daniels, because Jack Daniels is rank, or at least I think it's rank. So today's setup is the Vupu Drag, and I have got my brand new purchase, the Cosmonaut RDA, on top by District 5. I absolutely adore this RDA. I've been using this RDA most of the week, and it's been fantastic to me. The bottle didn't explode all over my mod, so that's a bonus, but I didn't have to squeeze it very hard for the liquid to come out. So let's have a vape. This is Duke by Royal Blend. That is smooth. That is really, really smooth. Where to start? I suppose on this vape, I don't tend to get much on the inhale, really at all. I think with tobaccos, it's all about that exhale, that smooth, woody flavor. And this juice seems to have it in absolute spades. Some tobaccos can come off kind of bitter, kind of harsh, a little bit chemically. This one has got this earthy, smooth, woody tone. It's nice and smoky, like a smoked whiskey would be, but with a tobacco. So you've got that sort of oakiness to it. And then right underneath, you've got those whiskey notes, and they come in right in that sort of aftertaste. You get that sort of hint of the malt and all the sort of things that go into whiskey. I mean, I'm not a whiskey expert, so I couldn't tell you what goes into a whiskey, but you definitely get that hint of it right on the exhale. This is a massively smooth vape. I was not really expecting that, to be honest with you. I think the packaging's a bit cheap, a bit gaudy, and just ripping off Jack Daniels is just lazy, if I'm honest with you. Okay, it's got whiskey in it. Let's make it look like Jack Daniels. No, that's just laziness. Come up with your own ideas. But the vape. Now, the vape is very, very nice. The liquid seems quite thin. It might be a thinner consistency of e-liquid. Just having a look on here. Let's have a look. So yeah, it is a 70-30, so it's not the thinnest in the world. It looks like it goes onto the RDA quite thin, but though that woody, earthy, smoky tone of the tobacco and that just the slight underhint of the whiskey makes it really interesting tobacco. I've had honey roast tobaccos, I've had chocolate tobaccos, I've had caramel biscuit tobaccos, I've had all sorts. Mixing it with that whiskey, because whiskey on its own is like, as a vape, I mean, I love to drink whiskey, but as a vape, whiskey on its own is awful, if I'm honest. So mixing it with that sort of earthy undertone is fantastic. I think this would work well with maybe like a caramel or a cream flavor. Cream would go really well. It'd make it really, really creamy. Tobacco cream works fantastically well. As far as purchasing this, I'll be honest with you, I've got absolutely no idea where to buy it from. The website I've stumbled across is a wholesaler, and it's one of those sort of contact us to buy jobbies. I cannot find it anywhere. I guess you're going to have to import it from Italy. There's no way that this is compliant. It's missing all the labeling. It just feels like it's not going to be able to be sold here. But you know, if you can find it, send me a link because I will want to buy more once I've finished it. I'm just not a fan of the branding of it. I think that's my biggest bugbear. But if you can get past that, which, you know, most people can, the vape is absolutely worth it. And if you like a tobacco vape, I think this is one you should have in your arsenal as one that you've tried because it's just unique, it's different, and it's really well done. So kudos to Royal Blend for making this as well as they have. Let's have another look at that ultra gaudy bottle. They've even put a milliliter sign on the back so you know how much you've got left. Which, you know, it's all right. What's it say on the side here? It says, Royal Blend, vape good, liquid made as our request made it for your generation. I bet that sounds better in Italian. But that's it. I think that's it. And I think it's a really sort of smooth vape, and I think you're going to enjoy it if you like your tobaccos. But for me, that flavour is gorgeous. I think that about wraps it up. It's a bit of a bumbly review that it's a little bit all over the place, but then so's this e-liquid. I don't know what to say about it, really. There's really very little info online on it. It's not a company I've heard of before, so I haven't really got much backstory to them. I think this would come in like my top three. I think the top one would be Elements Honey Roast. I think the second one would be the Late Night, a Quiet Owl. And I think number three has got to be this. And the little try that I had on whatever tester tank they had was pretty good, which is why I bought it. And that only cost me a fiver at the trade show. Now, that was probably a trade show price, but that only cost me a fiver. I think that about wraps it up. Thank you for watching this video. My name has been Cass. If you enjoyed this, please hit that like button, smash the subscribe button, and don't forget to hit that notification bell. That is super important. YouTube is changing the way that it shows you videos that you're subscribed to by not showing them to you because it decided that chat show recaps is more important than the original content that you've subscribed to. Make sure to hit that notification bell. If you enjoyed it, please leave a comment below. I will see you guys in the next video. My name has been Cass, and have a wonderful evening. Bye-bye.